Look at this diagram. Here, these are the elements of the communication cycle, means how the communication process will work in a cyclic way, means in a continuous mode. So first of all is the sender. Sender means who wants, sender is a person who wants to convey the message. Clear? And sender initiate the message to send to the receiver, to be sent to the receiver. So in order to be a good source, you need to clear about the message that you are choosing. Okay, that you are sending. Next is a message. Message means idea. Okay, idea is the subject of the message. Clear? This may be an opinion, attitude, feeling, views, orders, or suggestions. Okay, so the message is simply in the information that you want to communicate. Next is a third element is a encoding. Encoding is the process of converting the message to be transmitted into symbols is called encoding. Clear? Next is the communication cycle. Using any medium, you will send the communication channel. Using any medium, you will send the message to the receiver. So this is called communication channel. Okay. The person who is interested in communicating has to choose the channel for sending the required information or ideas, okay, to the receiver. You can send your information using certain channels. Okay, next is a receiver. Next element, receiver means a person who received the message or for whom the message is made for. Clear? So next is a decoding. Decoding, the person who received the message, that is a receiver, okay, or symbols from the communicator tries to convert the same in such a way so that he may extract its meaning to his complete understanding. Okay, so converting the message into his understandable form is called decoding. So next is a feedback. Very important feedback. Feedback is the process of ensuring that the receiver has received the message and understood in the same sense as sender wants to send. Okay, and as sender meant it. Okay, then receiver will send feedback to the sender.